thought that last match was the best of the best, the cream of the crop of the independent cruiserweight. But now you got a four-way with Scoot Andrews, and as you see right there, the former ECW World Tag Team Champion, Tony Mameluke, and two of the other best cruisers, four heavyweights, I don't care what you want to call them. There's Mike Sullivan with a beautiful ecstasy, and he's going to be followed shortly by the fallen angel, Christopher Daniels. You're very aware of all these competitors.
Absolutely, Ron. I'm aware. Spoke to Scoot Andrews and Mike Sullivan. There's a history there. Both former IPW heavyweight champions. Scoot Andrews, a long time. IPW champion Mike Sullivan also held that belt for a long time. And a match like this does not come along often, not just here, but anywhere.
Scoot Andrews, this morning of the match, he had the cast taken off his leg he had a horrible break of his leg. The doctors told him they didn't want him to wrestle. I'd like to see her and act like this is some big storyline, but the truth is, Scoot Andrews had no business in the ring, but he demanded Eddie get in there. He signed the release. This isn't an elimination match. First man that pins, first man that gets submitted, they're out. That's it. End of the match. The man gets his hand raised. No elimination, Bobby.
Absolutely, Ron. I agree with you. Scoot, there's no way Scoot should be in there, but you know you're not going to tell Scoot. The doctor said he should not be in there. Broken tibia. There's no way he should be in there.
Tony Mameluke, he's in there with Andrews. Mameluke's been in there with some of the best. He's been there with Rob Van Dam. He's been there with Sabu. He's teamed up with one of the best guys on the independent scene today when he teamed up with, I forget what his name is, can you tell me? Little Guido from the FBI. Sometimes I forget about people that are not on the IPW and FOW rosters, to be honest with you, Bobby.
And those rosters are so big, Ron, there's not many guys who aren't on those rosters. We both combined, Florida has always had the best talent, as proven right here by Mike Sullivan and Scoot Andrews, and it's just phenomenal.
You talk about phenomenal. We drew 600 people to this show. Everybody says Florida has been burned to the ground. Everybody said it's been raped and pillaged. There's no way of bringing wrestling back to Florida. We drew 600 and we thought that was the best we could do. The following night down at Davie at the Rodeo Arena, you drew 3,000 fans. Florida wrestling is back on the map, people. FOW, they're taking over the South. IPW's got North Florida covered. Pretty soon, you don't know what we can do combined. Scoot Andrews and Mike Sullivan, Mameluke and Daniels. This is just the beginning of what we can do. Look at that huge schoolboy by Sullivan.
Ron, nice exchange, nice wrestling act and Scoot. Almost a pinfall.
Sullivan's going to take opportunity when it's there. Ecstasy escorted him out to the ring, but he sent her to the back because he didn't want the hardcore giant Ron Nemi at ringside. He didn't want Ecstasy at ringside. This is a pure wrestling match. They don't need any extra gimmicks. And you see Tony Mameluke and Mike Sullivan. Again, like I said earlier, there's a counter for every counter. How many different ways can there be to put on a headlock, Bobby? I've probably seen just six right now.
Absolutely. Like I said earlier, and I mean that truly, I'm shooting here. You know, when I say a match like this with these four independent guys is top of the line. You ain't going to see this up north. You ain't going to see this anywhere, a match like this.
Like I mentioned earlier, Tony Mameluke was trained at the Malenko School of Wrestling, one of the best schools in the history of wrestling. But there you see him, the fallen angel Christopher Daniels, probably the biggest independent star on the internet today. He's a big star in Japan. He's a big star in Puerto Rico. We're lucky to have him here in IPW.
Absolutely, Ron. It's a real treat for the fans. It's a treat for me to sit here and commentate a match like this with you.
But look at Mike Sullivan. He's not intimidated. He's not in awe. What he does is he levels Christopher Daniels with a huge lariat.
Of course, Sullivan's going to take it to him. A win for any one of these guys. A pinfall over Daniels, a pinfall over Mameluke. For any one of these guys, you know, it's going to skyrocket them.
Mike Sullivan and Scoot Andrews working together. That's not too often that you see that. It isn't too often that you see Mike Sullivan working in cahoots with anybody other than the members of 911 Incorporated. Like I was saying earlier, Scoot Andrews, he's injured. He shouldn't be in the ring, but he's in there taking over on Chris Daniels.
Oh, Ron.
Tony Mameluke misses a Hurricane Rana. Oh, my God. Mike Sullivan, lucky he didn't break his leg. Gets knocked off the top rope by Christopher Daniels and unfortunately hooks his leg on the top rope. That could have been a horrible, horrible injury.
Absolutely, and you don't know, you know. Mike could be injured there, possibly not showing it, not going to let on.
See, that's the thing with these guys. Sometimes you think everything's fine. Sometimes you think they've had a hell of a match and that they'll be back the following night. Wow!
Oh, my God.
What the hell is Mameluke doing? That's what made him famous in ECW, is a total disregard for his own body and for the body of the person he's in the ring with. And there's Christopher Daniels going right to work on that leg. And there's a huge Japanese leg whip. And look at Scoot Andrews. He's in more pain than I even care to elaborate on. The doctor was right. What the hell are you doing, Daniels?
Taking the chair right down. You know, Scoot, broken tibia.
Yeah, and he's not healed. He has no business in the ring. And you see the referee, the mullet, Richie Rich. He comes in safety first in IPW. Yes, they're there to try to get a payday. Yes, they're there to try to get a victory. But the truth is we don't want anybody injured. If everybody can go out there and do their job, Chris Daniels, he knows better than this, Bobby.
The referee's back and Daniels up. Scoot is apparently really hurt.
And there's Rasta Man coming out checking on Scoot Andrews and Agent Steele. That's the camaraderie of the IPW dressing room. Scoot Andrews didn't give up. He didn't submit. He didn't get pinned. I don't even know what to say. This match continues now as a three-way between Chris Daniels, Mike Sullivan, and Tony Mamaluke because Scoot Andrews is being escorted to the back by Rasta Man and Agent Steele. And thank God the mullet Richie Rich has got the presence of mind to keep this match going and can keep the crowd happy.
And now it looks like Scoot is back at ringside there.
This is about 25 minutes into the match. Due to editing reasons, we had to cut it down because of time constraints. Scoot Andrews comes out and levels Christopher Daniels with the crutch. Mike Sullivan hits him with a huge slingshot face buster, covers him for the pin. One, two, three.